From the I-Team tonight, despite handling more than 4,200 criminal matters in the past 3 years, only a few of the cases prosecuted by one specific office ever made it to trial.
The numbers are shockingly low, even in a time when plea bargains have become the norm. Investigative reporter Travers Mackel has that story.
Norman and Camille, when you break down the numbers, only a fraction of all criminal cases in the country end up at trial. If this is the nation's caseload, then this is what makes it through to the trial stage, about 10% of all cases. But in St. Bernard Parish, the numbers are so low, we can barely represent them. Not 5% of all criminal cases, not even 2%. Less than 0.1% of all criminal cases actually end up in a courtroom, and that's raising some serious questions. The St. Bernard Parish Sheriff has his troops out in force.
We'll be ready to go.
On a pre-dawn morning drug sting.
It's an undercover roundup that we're going to be doing this morning.
Sheriff Jimmy Pullman and his deputies gave suspected drug dealers an early wake-up call, cuffing and stuffing more than 50 people in March, and prior to that, arresting dozens of other suspects in September of 2012.
Sir, is there any reason you keep doing this?
Through sweeps like this one, Pullman and his team are going after repeat offenders, the small segment of society that can generate big problems. But an arrest is no guarantee of a conviction, and a conviction in St. Bernard Parish is no guarantee of a long sentence. In fact, documents we reviewed show that in the last 3 years, the district attorney's office has never used the habitual offender statute on anyone in St. Bernard Parish. Rafael Goyeneche with the Metropolitan Crime Commission says in the past decade or so, the habitual offender statute has become a darling charge and a powerful weapon for all prosecutors.
That is a tool that the legislature enacted back in the 70s for public safety purposes.
The habitual offender statute allows district attorneys to seek serious jail time for anyone convicted of more than two felony offenses. It was put in place to make it easier to keep career criminals off the streets. In some cases, life in prison without the possibility of parole becomes a sentencing option. A spokesperson for Orleans Parish DA Leon Canizero says prosecutors at Tulane and Broad use the habitual offender statute almost daily in an attempt to keep certain criminals locked up longer. But despite dealing with 1,400 cases yearly, many of those involving repeat offenders, the St. Bernard Parish DA's office has never used the statute.
It's absolutely odd it's never been used in St. Bernard.
And that isn't the only unusual discovery we made. Those records we pulled show that over the last 3 years, only three criminal cases have actually gone to trial. That number includes both judge and jury trials. In fact, in 2010, the St. Bernard Parish DA's office handled nearly 1,400 criminal cases, and not one trial of any sort took place. The trend continued over the next 2 years. Despite handling, on average, 1,400 cases annually, records show only one went to trial in 2011, followed by just two in 2012.
You go to every section of court.
Legal analysts say the numbers are shocking.
I think it's going to catch people off guard. They're going to look at it like they're not doing any work down there.
By comparison, Washington Parish, with a population nearly the same as St. Bernard, held 24 criminal trials last year. In another comparable parish, St. Charles, records show about 15 cases went to trial in 2012. That's five times the amount of St. Bernard's three-year total. Even one of the state's smallest parishes, LaSalle, with a population of just over 10,000, held seven trials last year, more than double St. Bernard's three-year total. National figures show that plea bargaining has become a widely accepted tactic, the rule rather than the exception. About 90% of all cases are settled by plea bargain nationwide, and in Louisiana. And while that's high, it still pales in comparison to St. Bernard, where less than 0.1% of the cases see the inside of a courtroom.
Anyone who would look at this and say three trials in 3 years is highly unusual. What's going on?
The district attorney in St. Bernard Parish is Jack Raleigh. He's 83 years old, is the state's longest serving DA, and is the only district attorney the parish has ever had. Raleigh previously served as sheriff, He was elected top prosecutor in St. Bernard in 1978. That's the year the parish became its own judicial district, separating from Plaquemines Parish.
We can ask these questions, that would be great.
We tried to ask Raleigh why his office so rarely takes cases to trial and why it hasn't used the habitual offender statute or three strikes law on repeat offenders. He declined to speak with us on camera, and we aren't the only ones that would like to get some added context.
That is very unusual, and I think he probably owes an explanation to the public.
Though Raleigh didn't want to discuss the matter, we do want to note that one reason why plea bargains may be so common is that they guarantee some form of punishment, either jail time, probation, or fines. There's no guarantee on any kind of punishment if a case actually goes to trial. Reporting on your side, I'm Travers Mackle, WDSU News.
All right, Travers, it's also cheaper than a trial, and it can spare victims from having to testify in court. But deals can mean lighter sentences. Coming up tonight at 10, a former district attorney weighs in on the numbers we've uncovered. And if there have only been three criminal trials in 3 years in St. Bernard Parish, why are five full-time judges needed? That's all coming up at 10. To see the public comments we used or the public documents we used as part of our report, log on to WDSU.com. A leading civil rights organization wants to know more about how a local district attorney handles criminal cases. It's a response we received when we brought the findings of the WDSU I-team to the local branch of the American Civil Liberties Union. It seems fewer than 0.1% of all criminal cases in St. Bernard Parish make it to trial. As investigative reporter Travis Mackle explains, the ACLU wants to know if defendants are being bullied into taking plea deals.
That advocacy group tells us that it's been looking into St. Bernard Parish for months at how cases are handled and how suspects are treated, and they say the numbers we've uncovered are concerning.
The longest-serving DA in Louisiana has taken only 3 cases to trial in the last 3 years. 3 out of more than 4,000. The numbers obtained by the WDSUI team show that plea bargains aren't just the standard under Jack Raleigh's watch. It's pretty much where all criminal cases end up.
There's always a concern with high numbers of plea bargains.
ACLU Executive Director Marjorie Essman and her staff have been looking into St. Bernard Parish for the better part of 2013.
It leads you to question why, whether people are being pressured somehow into taking pleas without understanding the consequences.
Essman says once a person pleads guilty to a felony offense, it's difficult to ever have that removed from their record. And she points out other consequences. For example, anyone convicted on a drug offense is not eligible for any type of government Pell Grant for college.
We can ask some questions, that would be great.
Raleigh told us he didn't want to sit down for an on-camera interview about how his office handles cases. But a former area district attorney did review the numbers.
Plea bargain itself is an effective way to move through the system and get cases out of the way.
Jack Capella is a former top prosecutor in Jefferson Parish, the state's largest, and an office that handled thousands of prosecutions annually. He was surprised by what we found in St. Bernard Parish.
Obviously, this is a very low number of cases that go to trial.
But the trial number is not the only statistic from St. Bernard that jumps out at Capella. Raleigh and his team of prosecutors have not charged anyone with the state's habitual offender statute in the last 3 years. And sources tell the I-team it's hardly ever been used in St. Bernard Parish over the past decade. The habitual offender statute is more commonly known as the three strikes and you're outlaw. It's a way to make sure career criminals stay behind bars for extended periods of time.
The habitual offender statute was created to make sure that those people who repeat crimes are given the stiffest sentences that they can get. And it is a tool. It is the sharpest tool in the DA's toolbox to use to get pleas.
But once again, records show Jack Raleigh hasn't used it for at least the past 3 years. And these numbers in St. Bernard have one watchdog group asking another question.
Is there a sufficient workload for the judges that we have to keep them as judges?
There are 5 elected judges in St. Bernard Parish. Again, only 3 criminal cases have made it to trial since 2010. While those judges oversee other legal matters and must sign off on any plea deal, it's literally been years since some of them have presided over a criminal trial. After Hurricane Katrina, the state Supreme Court issued recommendations on the number of judges a parish should have. We checked. Recommendations for St. Bernard Parish, 2 judges. But Rafael Goyeneche says, don't expect any drastic changes.
But I can't remember the last time in Louisiana that a judgeship was removed from a jurisdiction.
That would require state lawmakers to get involved, and there is no legislation filed in Baton Rouge to shrink the size of the St. Bernard Parish Court. But Esmond says the numbers we've uncovered should get the attention of voters.
We have had some concerns, we've had some complaints, and I think the whole pattern is worth looking at.
By the way, each of those judge positions in St. Bernard Parish pays a salary of $130,000 a year. Those are full-time jobs. Something else worth looking at, the salaries Jack Raleigh pays his assistant district attorneys for essentially part-time work. Put it this way, they make close to double what some full-time prosecutors are making in much larger parishes. That story coming up tomorrow at 6.
In a parish struggling to make financial ends meet, where layoffs became a harsh reality last year, the WDSU I-team has learned prosecutors are making more than their counterparts in other, even larger parishes, even though they hardly ever take a case to trial.
But I don't think people fully understand and comprehend the cost of employing professionals.
After he reviewed what the WDSU I-team uncovered, the parish president is now looking at making some changes. Investigative reporter Travers Mackle has a breakdown of those numbers. Travers.
Camille, in St. Bernard Parish, plea bargains are the norm. Nearly 100% of felony cases, and not with a trial, but with a deal. So without a witness on the stand or a jury in the box, we were surprised to learn that the people who seek justice for the citizens of St. Bernard cash some of the highest paychecks in the region.
There were pink slips aplenty at the St. Bernard Parish Government Building in late 2012. Nearly 100 people were affected when the payroll took a big hit.
We're going to court.
Parish President Dave Peralta says the moves were a last resort, but he had no choice.
The cost of government has gone up.
That comes as the St. Bernard population remains below its pre-Katrina numbers. Prior to the 2005 storm, almost 70,000 people lived in St. Bernard Parish. That number now hovers just above 40,000. But despite the dire financial times and the smaller population, those who work as parish prosecutors are taking home sizable paychecks. There are 8 assistant district attorneys in the office. Records obtained by the WDSUI team show of that staff, 7 earn a salary north of $75,000 a year. 5 take home more than $81,000. Peralta knows the salaries will upset some who were let go by the parish.
I think some people will, but I don't think people fully understand and comprehend the cost of employing professionals.
By no means is $75,000 or $85,000 a lot when compared to the compensation of private practice attorneys. But salaries in that range meet or exceed those of most assistant DAs in both Jefferson and Orleans parishes, much larger parishes with much heavier workloads. A spokesperson for Orleans Parish DA Leon Canizero says the starting salary for a prosecutor in his office is just over $45,000 a year. In Jefferson Parish, that figure is just over $50,000. As the WDSUI team first reported earlier this week, prosecutors working in St. Bernard Parish take very few cases to trial. The plea bargain rate tops 99.9%. Records show out of about 4,200 criminal cases handled over the last 3 years, only 3 have gone to trial.
If you can ask some questions, that would be great.
Longtime DA Jack Raleigh didn't answer our questions about the practice or the way salaries are set. But we do know several members of his staff are veteran attorneys, something that would likely earn them additional financial consideration. Supervisors and the most senior members of other DA staffs also earn $80,000 or more, but they make up only a small percentage of the prosecutor's pool. In St. Bernard, it's the standard. And we've learned something else that gives St. Bernard prosecutors a chance to earn more than those in similar positions in neighboring parishes. Unlike prosecutors in Jefferson and Orleans parishes, ADAs in St. Bernard can have their own private law practices, and they can manage cases that are centered inside St. Bernard Parish as long as they are civil matters. Records we've obtained from the clerk of court show that the criminal docket in St. Bernard Parish is handled once every 2 weeks, on every other Tuesday, meaning ADAs are typically in a courtroom on parish business only a couple of times a month. The salaries, the staffing, the scarcity of courtroom business.
Three criminal jury trials
have caught the attention of the Metropolitan Crime Commission.
A, do they need that many? And B, do they have to be paid so highly when they're allowed to have private practices simultaneously?
In Louisiana, in every judicial district, prosecutors are paid at least in part with state funds. The first $45,000 of their salaries comes from state coffers. Anything beyond that is determined and paid out by the individual parish. Based on the records we've obtained, that means St. Bernard used at least $243,000 in parish funds last year to bolster the salaries of Jack Raleigh's ADAs.
Parish court work or something.
Former Jefferson Parish District Attorney Jack Capella looked at the numbers for us.
It jumps out is that that's a lot of money for assistant DAs, and are they being used effectively? The only one that can judge that are the people of St. Bernard.
Parish President Dave Peralta says the council decides how much money the DA gets each year. And with the parish trying to tighten its belt, changes could be on the horizon.
Could there be reductions in salaries, not only for assistant district attorneys, but as for that matter, also for people who work in parish government on a normal basis? Yes, it's quite possible.
Once again, assistant district attorneys in Orleans and in neighboring Jefferson Parish cannot participate in outside law practices, but that's not a universal rule. We checked in other parishes similar in size to St. Bernard and found prosecutors are sometimes allowed to conduct business on the side, but again, we're told those positions pay far less than the salaries that are paid out in St. Bernard Parish.